Question number 2. Ekta earns rupees 1500 in 10 days. How much she will earn in 30 days? Okay. So here she is earning rupees 1500 in 10 days. Okay. We have to find for 30 days how much she is earning. Okay. In order to find for 30 days, first we have to find for 1 day. Okay. So look at the sum. Okay, so 10 days it is 1500. Therefore, for 1 day, how can we find? We have to divide. Okay, so whenever you are finding for 1 day, okay, for many days it is given and we are finding for 1 day. So we have to divide. So 1500 divided by 10. So 1 0 from the numerator and denominator can be cancelled. Now we have 150 divided by 1, which is nothing but 150. Okay, so for 1 day she is earning 150 rupees. Okay, now we have to find how much she is earning for 30 days. Okay, so we for finding for 30 days we have to multiply 150 into 30. Okay, now when you multiply them, 150 into 30, no? So 150 you have a 0. So I am taking only 15. Okay, 30 also you are having 10. Take only 3. Okay, so when you multiply them, 3 5s are 15, carry over 1, 3 1s are 3 plus 1, 4. Okay, now 150, no? So you have 10, add that 0. Okay, and 30 also you are having one more 0. 30 you have 10, no? That 0 you can add. Okay, so the money earned in 30 days, it is equal to 4500. Either this way you can multiply, or you multiply 150 into 30. Okay, whichever way you are comfortable, you can do. So 150 into 30 also you can do. So 0, 0, 0, again 3 table you have to multiply. So 0, 5, carry over 4. So you are getting 4500. This way also you can multiply. Okay, I told you the easy way. Okay, so for 30 days she is earning 4500 rupees. Clear, children? Now third question. If it has rained 276 millimeter in the last 3 days, how many centimeter of rain will fall in one full week, that is 7 days? Assume that the rain continues to fall at the same rate. Okay, so here for 3 days, okay, it is raining, okay, 276 millimeter. Okay, therefore we have to find for 7 days. So unitary method. So first we have to find for 1 day. Okay, so the measure of rainfall, okay, in 3 days, it is equal to 276 millimeter. Okay, so for 3 days, it is 276 millimeter. Okay, now the measure of rainfall in 1 day. Okay, how can we find for 1 day? We have to divide. Okay, so 276 divided by 3. Okay, now 3 table, can I cancel them? So 3 1s are 3. Okay, 3 9s are 27. 3 2s are 6. Okay, so 92 divided by 1. So that is equal to 92 millimeter. Okay, this is the measure of rainfall for 1 day. Okay, now we have to find the measure of rainfall for 7 days. Okay, so measure of rainfall in one full week, okay, that is in 7 days. How can I find? I have to multiply 92 and 7. Okay, so when you multiply 92 and 7, 7 twos are, how can you multiply 92 and 7? 14. Okay, 7 nines are 63 plus 1, 64. Okay, children, so 644 millimeter. Okay, so now in your question, it has been asked that how many centimeter of rain. So centimeter of rain, but our answer it is in millimeter. Okay, so how can we write that in the form of centimeter? Now how can we write this millimeter in centimeter? We know 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Yes or no? This formula we know. Okay, from this what is 1 millimeter? Okay, we have to divide. So 1 divided by 10 centimeter. Yes or no? Okay, now we have to find for 644 millimeter. So 644 millimeter will be equal to, okay, 644 divided by 10. Okay, so 10, how many zeros are there in the denominator? 1 0. So in our answer we have to place a decimal before one number. Okay, so 64.4 centimeter. Okay, since it is given how many centimeter of rain will fall, we are expressing this in the form of centimeter. Clear, children?